All right, my fellow rock and rollers, we got here is a Marantz model 2330B stereo receiver. We're gonna try it out with my L100 Classics, as well as a CD that I bought at the same shop. Now, I got this audiophile copy of Elton John's Goodbye Yellow Brick Road. Now, I never had any problem with any Elton John music on my channel before we're getting flagged. So we're gonna try it and see what happens. Look at that, these mobile fidelity discs will have these fancy cases. And they're in the back of them is gold. So we're gonna try it out for starters. Excellent record, by the way. If you haven't heard it yet, highly recommended. So we're gonna do which should be a very, very good test. I got my buddy over here just kind of chilling. Trying not to get too loud for you, pal. All right, turn the volume down. I did not fire this up yet. The relay's on, it's already in stereo. Clean up with some deoxit, should be fine. Keep it flat for now. Oh, let's see. You are an exit. Nope. There we go. Beautiful. All the lights work on it. Sounds great. You can expect of a receiver of this age.
It's pretty much ready. This plug and play, ready to go. That sounds freaking good.
again.
Double Decker Records, Allentown, PA. That sounds incredible. That should be it for the sound demonstration. What we'll do real quick is I'll bring these a little closer, put you back on the tripod deck. It's more still because, let's face it, we all know that my camera movement skills are not the best. All right, so it's a bit functionality wise, it's pretty simple, which is good. AM, FM, phone, which Kenny has no interest in records. Cassette or tape, whatever you want. There's a tape monitor, so you can use that for an equalizer, or, you know, a tape deck to monitor your recordings. I would just do that and use tape 2 as a second auxiliary. Obviously, a CD player in Kenny's case will be using it for, the TV for movies and whatnot. Balance, everything's really good. Unit works perfectly. I'm just going to go over it with some deoxic, get the controls cleaned up a little bit. I do have the antenna hooked up, and I'll show the back before we call it quits. Let's go to FM. That should be MMR right here. It's definitely not WMR. That is. MMR. So it's needles off by a second, but I can get that no problem. Sounds amazing. WSTW out of Wilmington, Delaware.
Will probably turn out to be better.
WIP.
And how you're going to accomplish that.
The Jesus Station, WDAC, Lancaster.
Was when he appeared at the Rookie Room 2 days
ago. There's a lot of high energy going on there. Don't ask me how I know. New Metallica. 95.1 CZO.
That sounds amazing.
Fast internet.
To take your business to the next level.
Not South Lights from Lehigh.
Incredible.
Investigating us.
WOGL. Everybody secretly loves this song. I don't care what you say.
And topped off with stovetop stuffing mix in a jar of hot.
Complain. Damper stand. So right now, 48. It's Survivor at the Hawk.
99.9.
Are you?
Oh, great song.
And trying to revive people.
Up to 1,000.
It's a beautiful thing.
New 23 Outlander, 29.5, 29 down.
Probably WIOQ, Q1021. Out of Philly.
Will your game day cooler with the refreshing paint?
That horrible song again. 1029 MGK. That was the same station as the last time, too.
I'm Craig Stevens. Question of the afternoon. Open up the iHeartRadio.
Yeah, Y102. They play the same songs over and over again. Alt 1045. Ken, you got yourself an awesome receiver. Worth every penny. .1055 WMGH. My favorite station along with WMMR.
Consulta en $20 of food. Boleto gratis. Trabajo 100%.
It's 106.7 out of Harrisburg. WMMR, System of a Down, hell yeah. Long story short, this receiver is amazing. A good look at your tuner will take a slow walk across it. Just want to clean it up a little bit for you, Kenny. Oh, if I didn't mention at the beginning of the video, this receiver is not mine. I bought this for my buddy, Kenny. I saw it on my way out and I asked how much, and one phone call away. So I got the roof antenna unplugged from my 4300 for now. These are not the best speaker terminals, but they don't have to be. They work. They're effective. They're not the worst either. It does have a fuse on it. Has two AC adapters, one unswitched and one switched. There's your tape ins and out. That one's your monitor circuit. That one there is just a regular input. Auxiliary input and your phonograph input, and of course your chassis ground. Some cassette decks have a ground, and most, almost all turntables are gonna have a ground. And yeah, is your antenna inputs, has a built-in AM antenna. Curious to see how the AM works. I was thinking about doing this and getting some LEDs for this, but I'm not gonna touch it. This thing looks beautiful the way it is. Like, it is perfect. Absolutely perfect. Does have a little scratch up at the top. Now, of course, for an actual, that's the only blemish I see on the whole thing. Now, obviously, if you were using this in an actual setup permanently, you would not have the CD player sitting on top of it. You would have the CD player on the bottom or on a different shelf altogether to let it breathe, unless you want to install a cooling fan. Thing is great.
Yeah, Surge and the Boys, System Up and Down, and Toxicity. You're on MMR, sending that one out to JC, rocking us on Staten Island right now. Hit me up on the big board at 39333. Thank you, JC. Also sending that out to Cassette and Rich, rocking us in Croydon, loving the System Up and Down.
Croydon, that's my old area.
On this Thursday, as you know, Preston and Steve's camp out.
I just wonder, that guy from Staten Island, he's probably listening online. I don't think WMR reaches anywhere in New York well, not easily anyway. Staten Island, I don't know. Kevin, you live in Long Island. Does WMMR reach Staten Island? I kind of doubt it, but maybe. Yeah, anyway, that's pretty much all I got to say about this for now. The thing works incredibly well. KB, you are not going to be disappointed. And if you look, it's the exact size as a 5220. And it'll be a matching cassette deck, too. I think you need to get yourself one of these. Anyway, Kenny, I can't wait to drive down to Pittsburgh area and drop this off to you. You're going to love it. And, yeah, to the rest of the viewers that are always joining me, rock on. Thanks for watching. Catch you next time. Oh, there's one thing I forgot to mention I didn't say that I wanted to say. You were driving a pair of speakers that request or recommend roughly a 200 watt per channel amplifier with 30 watts per channel. Now, granted, these old Marantzes are very conservatively rated, so this is probably putting out more like 50, maybe even 60 watts. But, you know, before clipping, obviously. Yeah. But still, it sounds incredible. And it had bass. I was expecting the bass on it to lack a little bit with these, but it didn't. It totally held its own. Now, obviously, that my 4300 is more appropriately sized for these, and it does drive them a lot better. But Kenny once said of the original L100s, which are literally a quarter of the price of these for about a grand for a good pair. And the ratings are actually dead on. So these are like a perfect match for the original L100s. But if somebody did want to drive a set of the JBL L100 Classics with a Marantz 2230, you could do it, and it will have very good results. I could listen to that for my main system if I didn't have the 4300. I would totally hook this up right now. Other than the Sylvania RQ3748, this is the third best sounding receiver I've ever heard, that being number one. Thing sounds incredible. And I only had literally about less than 20 minutes with it, and I already love it. I kind of don't want to give it up. But anyway, yeah, I mean it this time. That's all. Take care. Peace out. Hope you enjoyed it. Rock on.